Welcome to the Thrasher's Wheat Radio Hour, where the feedback is back.
I come down from the misty mountain.
Every week we scour the human highway to bring you the best Neil Young news and reviews, rumors and musings, plus rare unreleased tracks and live shows that will keep you rocking in the free world.
It's all one song!
The Thrasher's Wheat Radio Hour is presented by WBKM.org in the heart of Burlington, Vermont.
Well, hello, everyone, around the country, around the world. Tony here with you. And here we are, back to another episode, a little distant from the last one, unfortunately. It's your Thrasher's Wheat Radio Video Hour. And as always, we're welcoming in on the other side of the screen, Thrasher. Good morning, Thrasher.
Yeah, good morning, Tony. It's good to see you. It's good to see everybody out there. It's good to catch up.
Absolutely.
But unfortunately, it sounds like we're here on the morning of September the 11th, 20 years ago, and our lives changed.
Our lives changed. 20 years ago and 20 years and about 3.5 hours ago, things happened to a whole lot of people for a whole lot of reasons. And I think the thing that I thought of when I woke up this morning was just really the personal aspect. The fact that there are some people today that that hear a screen door slam and think absolutely inappropriately someone's coming home that isn't coming home. And for those people who bear that burden in their hearts, mothers, fathers, sisters, brothers, friends, lovers, wives, enemies, we respectfully have it in our hearts and in our minds today that a terrible thing happened to a lot of very ordinary people, and that we will never forget. I know one person I want to thank that has nothing to do with any of this or us. But I want to thank John Stewart for being such an unstoppable force in the effort to see first responders and other victims who need medical help be taken care of by our United States Congress, who did a woefully poor job. So thank you, John Stewart, on this 9/11. I think about you, a true New Yorker.
Yeah, Tony. Good words. There's so many heroes and so many stories.
Yes, sir. And there was a thing called the tribute to heroes that we were just talking about this morning, which I think was something around 10 to 12 days after 9/11. And, you know, music, sometimes all you can do is sing a song. Maybe Neil did say singing a song won't change the world. And maybe it didn't change the world, but maybe it did give people a chance to mourn, to cry, to smile, even to say, but we are here. And that was a beautiful and amazing series of performances by stellar musical guests.
Yeah, Tony, absolutely. You know, like you say, a lot of heroes like John Stewart, and but you know, really, we can talk about, you know, all of these different things, but we all know who the real heroes were. Those are the ones who run towards the tragedy to assist and help. And then there's everyone else who either stands by or runs in the opposite direction. Mm-hmm. So hats off to those who run towards danger. And, you know, for us, you know, from the Thrasher's Wheat, from the Neil Young Rust, you know, Neil Young community, a few things. So, as you mentioned, after the show, or after 9/11, there was that tribute to heroes that Neil Young and many other artists performed on. And for many, you know, the most memorable moment of that night, of that telethon and fundraiser for the heroes, was Neil Young's performance of John Lennon's song Imagine in a darkened studio on a grand piano surrounded by hundreds and hundreds of candles. I know at the time that night after that was broadcast, I received several calls from several friends that I had not heard from in many, many years, who said that they had just watched that and they really thought that Neil just nailed it. And, you know, they thought of us, of me, because of, they know I'm a big Neil Young fan. But, you know, for the past 20 years, really, just about every day on September 11th, on Thrashers, we put up the clip of Neil Young doing the Imagine song, and, you know, sort of, you know, doing a memorial of that day. And, you know, I think we'll just sort of wrap up here. And the last thing I'll say, you know, is that event really led to, if you will, the resurrection of Thrasher Suite. This blog, as you know, has been running for 25 years. It started in 1996, but it was really in the aftermath of 9/11 that really, really started to take off, where, you know, I sort of made a daily commitment to blogging every day. Up to that point, it's just been sort of a hit or miss, you know, kind of did what I felt like doing every now and then. But that's when we moved into the daily format. So it was really the combination of needing to speak out about what was going on, and a lot of it was sort of ultimately captured in the Green Day album, but not to digress too much here. Mm-hmm. But yep, hats off to the heroes.
Yeah. So singing the song did change the world for you and for a lot of folks who come to depend on Thrasher's Wheat as a Neil and a musical source of good information. So hats off to you too, Thrasher, for doing that. Glad you did. And well, we move from one tragedy to another near tragedy. And I think that you and I were both personally offended by the reality that a tree hugger such as you, who thought you had a deal with the trees, did not have a deal with the trees, apparently, in a very sadly Seinfeldian way, because you, a tree, and a great big storm collided one night 2 months ago.
Yeah, Tony. There's a lot of, I guess, irony here that we are recording this on the anniversary of 9/11, certainly a national, global tragedy that changed our lives. Mm-hmm. But in a way, I think, you know, this is just part of the serendipity, synchronicity of Thrasher's Wheat, about how these things kind of come together. Really, you know, I think, as we sort of mentioned before we got going here, you know, I really don't want to dwell too much on the past of these, you know, national, global tragedies or our personal tragedy. Mm-hmm. But, you know, I will just say, you know, a couple of things just right off the top, you know, which, first and foremost, we have heard from so many people, friends, family, Neil Young fans, over the past few weeks, and we truly appreciate everyone's, you know, support and sympathies and well wishes and all that. Thrashette, myself, we're going to be fine. We're going to be fine. You know, as they say, it's just stuff. And we'll get out of this. But, you know, I think when we put this up on the blog, you know, originally to share the news, you know, the takeaway for us really was, we had been at a concert that night. We'd been out at the local amphitheater, Wolf Trap. I think, you know, many who know us know that we go to the Wolf Trap amphitheater every summer, see a lot of shows. It's a beautiful place. It's one of the most beautiful concert venues in the country, you know, really right up there with Red Rocks in terms of just being a phenomenally acoustically beautiful place to hear music outdoors. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we were, you know, doing what we were doing, you know, on a nice, wonderful summer night, you know, had our picnic, you know, checked our weather forecast, all that kind of good stuff, went to the concert, you know, came home, you know, heard a little thunder, heard a little lightning, you know, walked in the house, boom, as you said, the big tree, you know, kind of came down and hit us. There's the root ball and the damage done there. So yeah, it took us out of commission. And you know, that house or our house behind there, you know, our bedrooms back there, you know, it was 11 o'clock at night. Probably if we had not been in that concert, we probably would have been in there. And, you know, there's no telling how that could have all turned out, you know, with some different timing and some different directions and so on. But we're safe, and we really, you know, dodged a big one there. So, you know, as we said, the music literally, you know, saved our lives. And I think obviously everyone knows, you know, we're big live music fans. And we're just, you know, thankful for the music and saving our lives, and we will rebuild and we will be back and hopefully, you know, good as new, better than ever. But again, you know, thank you everyone for your thoughts and prayers and sympathies and kind words. And sorry we have not gotten back to everyone, you know, individually about all of this, but we did see, and you know, lots of comments on the blog, but thank you. We love all of you guys and want to see you soon.
And it is certainly the preeminent reason why there has been a delay in from the previous video to this one. There are some little things like holes in roofs and water coming into houses that shouldn't be coming into a house. So you will bounce back. You and Thrashette will bounce back personally. And I know that Thrasher's wheat will carry on when it's ready to be put back into shape and carry on again. So we look forward to that. And live music. Well, there's some live music in the future. Well, it's there whether we're there or not. Whatever we do, the live music is there. But we got a concert. It's September. As we know, September 11th. And so two Saturdays from today. Wow, I just realized that. There's this great big thing called Farm Aid coming on up. Hartford, Connecticut this year. A return to Hartford where the show was in, was that 2018?
Yeah, 2018, yep.
Oh, okay. So, another great collection of musicians coming on to share this beautiful day of music and celebration of the family farmer, the American and the Canadian as well, family farmer. And this is going to be a great thing in that last year there was no real concert attending. It was all virtual. It was done and it was streamed from all over the place. This is happening in a real place. As I mentioned, Hartford, Connecticut, great venue. It's going to be a sunny day because that's just what we always expect. So we take care of that with the powers that be. And, unfortunate for all of us, will be the absence of Mr. Neil Young. The first Farm Aid that Neil has not participated in, unless I'm missing something somewhere in the past. But and this is as a continuation of our difficulties with this pesky virus. And Neil made a personal decision, which affects lots of people, Personal decisions are never quite entirely personal, are they?
Yeah, Tony. Why don't you continue along here with a little bit of the other, I guess, farm aid, whatever you want to call it, news here, and then we can get to Mr. Neil and his decision.
Sounds good. So to refer to, you know, one of the things on people's minds is, okay, well, great. So we got the show. It's in Hartford. Rules. What are the rules? What rules do we might not we've heard of? What rules do we need to remember? And straight from the horse's mouth, that farm aid, the rules are simple to manage. One must present proof of vaccination in order to attend. This is whether it be for concert goers who have a ticket, media, broadcasters, photographers. If you're coming in to the venue, you have to have proof of vaccination. Or a negative test done within, I think it must probably be within 72 hours, which is usually the standard. You don't need both. You need one or the other. And the other thing that is out there is a ordinance in the city of Hartford, which is that masks must be worn indoors. And I think that the definition of indoors here is a little sketchy. In that this is one of those venues that is that has a large lawn and then has a covered roof over a stage with the covered seating. I don't believe that's called indoors because it is open on three sides, except it's just not open over your head, which is fortunate sometimes, although we have a sunny day in store, so maybe it doesn't matter. But I think that it would be wise to stuff a mask in your pocket, and I don't have an expectation of needing it in the venue with the in your seats, but it's still 2 weeks away, and well, if we've seen anything during this entire era of illness in the last year and a half to 2 years, is that things change radically, quickly, or not at all. So depending on your level of confidence in that, stick a mask in your pocket and let's all just do what we got to do in order to share the music and share the friendships. I have friends that I look forward to seeing every year that I talk with all during the year. And this is the one great day when we get to finally get to see each other and give each other a hug. And there will be hugs.
Yeah. 2 weeks out, Tony. I know we've been looking forward to this day for some time.
Oh yeah.
Obviously before Neil's withdrawal announcement. And Tony, I think you're well aware that over the past few years we've been traveling to Farm Aid and sitting with the Farmadians, our Canadian Farm Aid friends, young fans, and our plan had certainly been earlier in the year, definitely absolutely would be there, but here we are 2 weeks out, and Tony, we do not know for certain whether we are going to be at Farm Aid or not. We certainly want to be.
Yeah.
There are a couple of sort of circumstances here. Obviously circumstance, one is sort of what we talked about just a moment ago. We've had quite a bit of disruption in our lives, but we're thinking we can sort of swing that part of it. But our Farmadian friends of getting on a bus and driving across the border and then getting back into Canada
that way.
there's uncertainty in the Farm Aid contingent of whether they themselves and their bus load of Farmadians will be there, and so our ticket, our plans really hinge on the Farmadians and their plans, and at the moment it's looking like this thing is going to go right down to the wire in terms of this. And so it's a little bit unsettling, but here we are.
Yeah, I think you're talking about Thursday the 23rd is sort of the point of no return here. Pull the brakes or full throttle. And you might not know until then. So that's a little nail biting.
Yeah, just more of exciting lives that we live here.
Yeah, we still got nails. I got a few at least. So, you know, there are some things that we are powerless to fix, and I think those are the toughest things. I'm a fixer, so I don't like things that can't get fixed.
Yeah.
And this is just one of those things. We're gonna go to the wire, do the best.
Yep. Well, okay. You know, Tony, I guess let's just get right to the heart of the matter here, and then we'll wrap up here. But as you mentioned, our Mr. Young here has decided that he is not going to be on stage with his farm aid brethren, Willie, John, and Dave. So, as you said, you know, it's a personal call, a personal decision that Neil Young has made. He did, you know, provide statements on his withdrawal from Farm Aid. It is the first time that Farm Aid will go on without Neil Young. Really, the guys, the board, if you will, has been solid. There's actually just three of them, and then Dave joined whatever it was 10 or 15 years ago. So, you know, Neil has made a decision, and it is very hard to just sort of let it just stand without a comment. This is, if you will, classic and typical Neil. I want to say classic and typical Neil from the standpoint of he does what he does and he lets the chips fall where they are, whether, you know, he has his convictions of what he thinks is right. And, you know, he obviously didn't have Elliot Roberts to, consult with this time around on this kind of a decision. I don't think anyone is going to really, fault him, for what he's done, because, you know, he is, if you will, following in a very long tradition of doing what he wants to do. Having said that, we ourselves we're looking forward to see Neil Young. Obviously, we have not seen him, or anyone has seen him for several years now, doing a live performance. We saw his little Zoom mini concert fireside session things, which were all very fine and all very nice. But we do know that he has been recording new songs. Certainly, you know, new music coming out is always a great thing and something we love here at Thrasher's Wheat, you know, the latest recordings. And we certainly, you know, expected, you know, some commentary on world affairs here. A lot going on. So it's a voice that would be missed. Certainly Neil has been someone who is, spoken truth to power. And that is something that we're disappointed that we will not be hearing this year. I mean, Neil has stood up for, obviously, the farmers at Farm Aid, you know, every year. You know, that was always kind of a little bit of a highlight of the concert, you know, the Neil Young going off for a couple of minutes. I'm sure, Tony, you remember a few of those rants.
Love the rants, because they were focused and they were pertinent to the day, to the times we are in, whether it's a t-shirt that talks about a company called Monsanto in less than glowing terms, or it's, whatever it is. And I guess to kind of go along with what you're saying there, you know, it is surprising when people act in a way that we don't expect them to act. I mean, it's just because that's us on our side of it. But I think you do hit the nail on the head on the other side, which is that Neil has a long and illustrious and sometimes not illustrious history of doing what Neil wants to do, firmly believes Neil wants to do. There is the famous, and I wonder if we'll see any t-shirts, could be some money in it. There's the famous eat a peach conversation or salutation in the letter to Steve Stills from many years ago. And this is not quite that. This is a personal conviction about large gatherings, about promoters, and about artists maybe being premature. But, you know, on the other hand, there is John, who is always quite clearly outspoken, well-spoken. Whether it's, I got nothing to say except F the politicians. That's it, period. Sit down, standing ovation, or lengthier. Or if it's Dave, who is always so literate, so educated in his understanding of the problems that face the American consumer over the food they eat. And then there's Willie, who, let's face it, you know, we've lost a number of folks younger than Willie. We just lost Charlie Watts. And every day, I think every day that we have Willie, every day that we wake up and Willie is with us and strong and able to play, is a great gift. So we look forward as always also to Willie, and Willie not just doing the last set of the night, but the Willie who comes out with the press, with the other folks during the press conference, the Willie that always has kind and good and positive things to say, the Willie who just wanders out on the stage sometimes and plays with folks that wasn't scripted. And that whole Nelson thing, that whole Nelson vibe that runs through it. And I know that you and I, if you make it, if I make it, we all make it. Well, I can't wait to hug my friends in Promise of the Real. Because, you know, that's, if Farm Aid is about anything, it is about real.
Definitely, Tony. It'll still be a great day, regardless of everything that we've just sort of been through here. And I look forward to seeing you, certainly. And hope to be there with all the Farmadians and make it happen. And, you know, you mentioned Promise of the Real. And I know this is, sorry, folks, might have been a little bit of a downer of a show, but we talked about how we could make sure that at the end of all of this that we left everybody on a pretty, pretty happy, upbeat note here, yeah. Tony. So you mentioned Willie Nelson and Promise of the Real and Lucas and Micah. So, we could go for a little bit of, how about a little Lucas Nelson, Promise of the Real, and a little bit of Farm Aid and from couple of years back, 2019, I guess that was in Milwaukee.
Yeah, the last real one we did. Very real.
Yeah, last time we saw each other. So what do you say? What do you just round it out here? Let it go and say, have a good day, everybody.
Yeah, I think so. You know, Lucas and Promise of the Real are on tour now. They've had a couple of shows under their belt. What I've seen out there on Instagram and various places, the band is grateful and extremely excited to be back out performing, doing what they do. There's a lot of practice, there's a lot of songwriting, there's been albums, but you know, for a band, a real band, a touring band, getting in front of people is a very big thing. And I know that we're going to see an explosive set from these gentlemen. Cold Promise of the Real with Lucas and with Micah adding in, jumping in occasionally. I'm looking forward to that. And this was a great moment in 2019. Find yourself. I mean, we were singing this on the way to the parking lot at night because it's just a very, it's a great song. It's a good song. It's got a great hook to it.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. Tony, like I said, it's good to catch up. It's good to get in touch with everybody out there. As we always say, no fear, but stay safe, take care of yourselves, look out for one another, love y'all, miss y'all. And just as Lucas and Promise the Real say, find yourself. Here we go.
Thanks, everybody.
Take care.
To call Yola out with us for this next tune. My friend Lady Gaga, but for this movie Star Is Born, and I showed her this song. She really liked it, was kind enough to sing on it. But we got Lola and Margot Price, and we also got the Night Sweats coming up with us. With Nathaniel, I don't know if Nathaniel's around, but we're gonna do a song called Find Yourself. We'd like y'all to sing along too, if you don't mind. We've got some parts for it. Tell me things I want. Let me hear the girls. I hope you find yourself. Yeah, come on, baby. You know, yeah, we men, we need to hear this sometimes. Tell it again. Tell me again. I know, I know, I know. Oh, well, guys, we have something to say too, though, don't we?
I hope you find yourself before I find somebody else.
Say it a little louder, gentlemen. Come on, guys, let me hear you. Y'all.